Hi there, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be one of the very important ones because that is about list comprehensions. So if you're not in the know, when developers like yourself and I, when I impress someone with their code, instead of using for loops or any loops, they try to use list comprehensions if the data that they are dealing with is of nature of a list. So I've got the Hackerrank on the left, so this is going to be where I will be submitting my code. I've got a Jupyter notebook on the right so that I can teach you on the side little bits and pieces that will help us to kind of tackle that problem really quickly and really efficiently. So let's go on and hit the solve challenge. Like every other time, what I really encourage you to do is read the task really carefully. In this type of test, you don't have a lot of time to waste. So if you don't really understand the task, you will end up submitting and submitting and submitting and not really getting there. So we've got the task explanation on the left. We've got the STDIN on the right, which is this white area. That's actually where I will be coding for Hackerrank. And if you haven't seen my previous videos, I really encourage you to go and check them out because this is a build-up. It's like you are climbing up a ladder and they're not really long. They're like 5-6 minutes. So they will give you a really good insight into how to tackle these problems and how to get that golden job. So as I have mentioned before, this part of the code is actually when we get the data from the user and do things on it. Put a cursor there and move it down. So let's call it, we receive data and take action. So I can definitely tell you that this is when we are receiving the data because we're saying, hey user, input X, input Y, input Z, and input N. Beautiful. But where is the take action bit? Well, let's make a placeholder of that, take action, and make sure to fill it up. We receive the data and take action. Beautiful. But what is the action? That's what we will be writing here. So this is find the action, or we write a function. Brilliant. So now we know what the outline is. Let's read the task really carefully. Let's learn about list comprehensions. Well, I'm going to stop right over there because I think this is a very critical point in time that if you don't know how to write a list comprehension, I highly encourage you to stay really focused on this bit. I'm going to jump on my Jupyter notebook, and what I'm going to show you is that how do we use list comprehensions instead of for loops on a list. Let's make a list. My list equals, let's just put some names. I've got Sam, I've got Jess, and I've got Taylor. Just three people. So normally, if I want to take them one by one and print their names and say, oh, hey, we've got Sam, we've got Jess, and we've got Taylor, what I normally do, I say for name in my list, print name. And what happens is that the computer goes ahead and says, okay, you want them one by one. So first name is Sam, I'm going to print it, Jess, and Taylor. What if I wanted to say that these three people are brothers and sisters, and I want to give their last name to them. So what I would have to do in a for loop, I would have to say, okay, once you get the name, what you can do, you can replace it with the name plus Smith, because that's their last name. And once you do that, you want to make a new list and append this new name to it. Well, I will have to make the new list outside the loop just to define it. It's just an empty list. And as we go on, we take Sam, we add Smith to it, and then we put that new name into the new list. So that's going to make my life easier. What I need to do, I will need to add a space before Smith, because if I don't do that, it will be like this, Sam Smith. And this is not what I want. I want to have Sam space Smith. Okay, so I hope this is easy for you to understand. Let's run that and let's look at my new list. Yes, I have the three brothers and sisters. I've got Sam Smith, Jess Smith, and Taylor Smith. I didn't really need to print this, but I just printed that so you could see what is happening. So let's get rid of that. What if I wanted to do all these four lines in simply just one line. How can I do that? So let's run that. Let's clear it. And I want to write everything in just one line. Look at this. New list. That's going to be my end goal. I want to have a new list that has concatenated people's name with their last names. Equals. Open square brackets and close square brackets. What we need to do now is what the operation is. The operation is to take a name and say plus space Smith. This is the operation. So I'm going to put that operation in the beginning. Then you start the loop. You say for name in my list. So as you can see, I have this line copied to the beginning of the list comprehension. Then I have for name in my list right down here. And I don't need this bit because that's essentially happening right here. Let's look at it. So let's run my list and let's run new list and let's print new list. Ta-da! See, I did write all these four lines in simply just one line that does the job for me. So this was a more of a string example. Let me give you another example. So let me just clear this a bit. I will keep these two lines and let's make move down. I will make another example with numbers. So I have got my number list. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever, those numbers. I don't care. It doesn't really matter. And what I want to do, imagine the question says, I want you to multiply them by 3 and give me a new list that has them multiplied by 3. So that's easy. For number in num list, what I want you to do, make a new num list. But remember, you have to make it outside to be able to use it. So new num list equals an empty list. And every time we append the number, did I say not times 3? Yes, I think I did. So every time, say number times 3 and put it in the new list. And then once you look at the new num list, you will see that, ta-da, you've got 3, which is 3 times 1, 6, 3 times 2, and so forth. So if I were to write this in a list comprehension way, now I know what to do. I will say new num list. So put your container, your new container on the left. That's my new container. Put open brackets and close brackets. What is the action? So you may be confused that, okay, probably this is the action. Not necessarily. This bit is the action. So what are we doing? We are saying times 3. So copy that. Bring it down here. So I want to take one number every time and times 3. But what is the loop? For a number in, what was my list? It was called num list. And if I print this one now, print new num list, you will see that I will get the same thing. So instead of 3 lines this time, I only have 1 line and that does the job. So this was a long one probably, but this is really important to understand what is a list comprehension. So it will make my life much, much, much easier to get this problem tackled. So let me get rid of all of that because I'm going to be using this. Now, let's learn about list comprehensions. Okay, we did it. You're given 3 integers, x, y, and z, representing the dimensions of a cuboid, along with an integer n. Print a list of all possible coordinates given by ijk on a 3D grid, where the sum of ijk is not equal to n. So, for example, the user gives me x is 1, y is 1, z is 2, and n is 3. So I'm receiving all of that here. I'm going to make a function, check sum, maybe just call it that, doesn't really matter. And x, y, z, and n, these are the variables that I'm going to be receiving from the user. So the user is going to pass these 4 to the action part. All I want to do now is that for every one of those x, y, z's, I want to be able to print any combination that they don't equal to n. So for example, I've got 1, 1, 2, and 3. So how about 1, 1, 2? Does that equal to 3? No, that's okay, because 1 plus 1 plus 2 equals 4, and that's okay. You can print it. How about 1, 1, 1? You can't do that because it will be equal to 3, and you can't do that. So look at this. All the permutations of I, J, K are 0, 0, 0, which all of the three are 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 2, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, so forth. Print an array of the elements that do not sum to n equals 3. So 0, 0, 0 doesn't equal to 3 if you sum them up. 0, 0, 1 doesn't, and so forth. So the only ones that are going to be problematic is 0, 1, 2, because that equals 3, and 1, 1, 1, because that equals to 3 as well. All right. So if I were to write this in a loop, I would write z equals 2 and n equals 3. This is just for one example, but what I'm doing here can check any number, any given combination. Let's just do one example at a time. So for I in range x plus 1, because you remember that range only goes until that range minus 1. So if I say I in range x, it will be just 0. But if I wanted to go from 0 to 1, I have to say go from 0 to 2 because it doesn't include the last one. Go check my other videos, my previous videos, I have talked about this a lot. So if I print I, you will see that. Oops, what's going on? Sorry, I should run the top one first. So this goes from 0 to 1. Brilliant. J, so x is 0, y is 0, y is 1. Now let's change x to 1, y 0, y 1. So this is only x and y, but we need to do that for j as for z as well. So let's say for k in range of z plus 1, I want you to print this is z and add k there. So now you can see that x0, y0, z0. Z adds one more. So z1, z2, and then now let's change y, and so forth. You just keep doing the inside loop. When it finishes, you go one more up, and then again, finish the inside loop. And then when both of them finish, you go one step up and continue like that. Okay, so let's get rid of these print functions because I don't want to see them. Now, what I'm doing right now, I'm just looping through those three elements. What I need to do, I want to say if I plus J plus K does not equal N, because that's what the task wants me, print I and J and K. Look at this. I have everything that's the addition of these three does not equal 3. Look at that. That's 0. Sum is 1, sum is 2, sum is 1, sum is 2, sum is 1, sum is 2, sum is 2, and sum is 4. Brilliant. So now I have it, I have the solution, but it's not in list comprehension. That's the problem. All I need to do is to follow the list comprehension. Do I need to store it somewhere? Yeah, if you want to, you can. So you can say new list equals open and close brackets. What will be the output of my code? It will be I, J, and K. And how do I write three loops in that? That's pretty easy. Just write them in one line. Let me just open my Jupyter notebook a bit. For I in range of x plus 1, and then for J in range, just write them one after the other, range of y plus 1, and for K in range of z plus 1. How do I say if the addition doesn't equal to n? Just add it to the end. So if I plus J plus K does not equal n. Let's run this. And let's print new list. Look at that. I got it. In a list comprehension, first write what do you want the output to be. That's my output. That's my desired output. Then write your for loop or for loops if you have many. And then write your condition. So now I know how to write this. Let me just minimize this. And I think I will just simply copy that and put it here. Oops, that's a long one. Let's just open this a bit up and open this a bit up. Okay, so you can see it easily. Now, this is going to be my list, and all I need to do is print new list. You have the action defined. You have the input. Now you need to take that action. All you need to do, what is the name of your function? I just called it checksum. You can call it pizza if you like, whatever you like. Checksum of X, Y, Z, and N. Beautiful. It worked on the test cases. Let's submit it and see if it works all test cases. Ta-da! This was a really good one. I hope you really enjoyed it. I got 10 more points. If you did like this, please hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel. I'm doing my best to help you get that perfect job. Thank you.